Hello, it's Monday, October 4th, and that means two things. It's UN World Space Week, and it's time for the Lighting Industry News Brief, brought to you by KeystoneTech.com and their brand new Direct Drive LED HID replacement lamps. These are great upgrades for existing technology. They come in 80-watt, 115-watt, two switches on those things, one for color, one for power, so you can keep your customers happy without a lot of SKUs kicking around. All these are available with a smart port G2 screw and sensor for motion sensing, daylight harvesting. That's light made easy. KeystoneTech.com. NEMA is calling, and others, three other agencies have called for supply chain fixes from the government. They have a list of demands related to tariffs and grants. We'll see how that goes out. Northeast China, 10 provinces there, are still rationing electricity. They've burned too much playing catch-up over the summer, and now it's starting to hurt them yet again. The DLC has finalized their surveillance testing program. The QPL process has been updated to match. At last count, there are more than 500,000 containers in the queue at LA ports. That pileup won't be getting better anytime soon. We have a recall on Defiant brand solar fixtures. This is from Home Depot. These are motion-activated fixtures that whose batteries might explode. The IES has published a consumer guide, a non-technical document to understand light for the aging eye. The UL has certified a solar luminaire. This is the first for the OOI number 8801. 2022's Architecture Light and Architecture Design Awards are open for entries, deadline December 10th. DOE is seeing energy use still improving over the past year. Great to hear. Get a Grip on Lighting features Sohana Arni talking about lighting for silence. Acuity is declaring a dividend, 13 cents per share this quarter. Beacon's share price is up 59% over last year. That was an announcement from their CEO on Wednesday. The Women in Lighting Design have released the results of their gender survey with some great infographics for you to check out. Zaga will be addressing circular economy in a white paper about repairability and standards for the future. ATG is opening a distributor central. This is a new web portal just for distributors. Vantage will be partnering with Environmental Lights for fixtures. In legal news, CAST has resolved all of the WAC Lighting's claims against them. That's all settled now. In horticultural news, you can make bigger tomatoes if you pump more green light on them. Glad to know. In events on November 3rd, Good Light Group will be presenting on SAD and winter lighting. We have Energy Focus presenting at LD Micro on the 13th. Jimmy 2 will be speaking there. In rep agencies, Keystone Tech has named Empire in NYC in northern New Jersey and Clifford in Indiana. In recommended reading, all these are on nail.org, and there will be a test next week, so watch out. We have Understanding Data Control and Usage in Smart Cities, The Role of Lighting in Healthcare Spaces, Where IoT Fits into Sustainability, Tips for Lighting Bars and Restaurants, Turlin Hughes launching their own podcast, UK advocates stating that streetlights won't stop crime, IoT adoption might be being slowed down by fear of patent suits. Penn State has their own podcast, starting with indoor lighting savings. The Wall Street Journal talks about LED lifespans. Travis Book is interviewed on outdoor lighting trends. Willard Ward talks of personal lighting controls. And we have a discussion, what will be the wiring of the future? Aluminum or carbon nanotubes? Considering that we tried aluminum and we hated it, I think it might not be that one. In market projections, smart poles will grow by 20%. Ambient lighting will reach $88 billion in value soon. Horticultural lighting is poised for 21% growth. Faux filament LEDs will be predicted to gain 20% in value. Lighting for heliports will grow by $19 million in the next few years. The fixture market will clock gains at 4%. Industrial and commercial LED will grow by 19%. And lighting control is projected to reach $8 billion in value by 2027. In IoT news, WISeKey has joined a cybercrime manifesto. This is part of a 50-group call to action. DALL-E 2 has set interoperability rules for emergency signs. WeSilica and Tridonic will be partnering on cloud-based wireless controls. In R&D, Legrand has proved the efficacy of their Indigo Queen line. This is through an ICANN study. The devices deactivate SARS-CoV-2 and common influenza. UC Irvine has begun the largest LiDAR traffic monitoring project. This is funded by the DOE and will use lasers to study 25 intersections. BioClock Consortium is hiring 23 spots. If you're a PhD candidate, you can sign on to a dozen different projects. In dark sky news, we have a lot of research. So circadian neurons fight inflammation in humans. Tridonic is testing tunable lights in Danish parks. We have light at night reducing anxiety of mice with cancer. Circadian rhythms linked to bone development. Cheatgrass actually grows better under artificial light at night. And the Royal Society is charting artificial light at night's harms on anemone fish. In local news, Guam has received $201 million in federal grants. Epcot, the most boring part of Disney, is showing off their new lighting on Starship Earth and the monorail. New York State has installed its 500,000th LED street lamp. In Indiana, they're offering home improvement grants to low-income groups. Midland, Texas has approved school board upgrades. Windsor, Ontario Parks will be installing new lighting. Rowlett, Texas has joined the PACE program. Coos Bay's food bank would like to thank the local Elks Club for their lighting upgrades. That's in Oregon. In People News, Rory Christian, formerly of Keyspan, is now the chair of New York Public Service Commission. Penny Hersher is now on the BOD at Smart Global Holdings. Mitch Beiser is retiring from Nightlight Landscape Illumination. Marie-Pierre Lestrat is the president of GIL. Michael Colligan has left Starving for Darkness. Lightline has promoted Gil Copperthorne and hired Brett Hickelman. And in Oddities, we can see the secret of uranium glasses glow, and you can consider upgrading your microwave with lasers. 700-watt blue laser away adds smokiness and cooks that much faster. Please don't do that at home or without proper equipment. Until next time, I've been Scott Wachter. Enjoy your week. Enjoy the music.